Today I'm going to do one of my favourite things, which is unbox makeup. I have a big bag here from Sephora full of goodies, which I got from... I'm actually really lucky. I didn't get any of this stuff for myself. It was my birthday last week and this was a present from my friend Dawn, who was in Barcelona, went into Sephora and just bought a whole bunch of things for me. So I have the best friends ever. I opened this on Sunday, but I was so excited. I can't really remember what was in it. I just pull things out of the bag, so I can't remember what's in it. And I haven't opened any of the products to swatch them or anything like that. So I thought I would do a little video and unbox everything and you can see what's inside the bag too. So first of all, I'm just going to open the first thing I'm going to pull out is this Beauty Boulevard Stardust. I don't know if you can see that. It is, these are the guys, Beauty Boulevard, they do the glitter for your lips. I saw them on Dragon's Den a couple of years ago and they're really good. Face, body and hair glitter. This is one of the professional kits. I have seen these before actually. You can also get these if you don't have a Sephora. Like me, if you're in the UK and we don't have a Sephora here, you can get these in Sally Salon Services. And they'll be really awesome for festival looks or raves or just like party nights, whatever. The next thing is Lord & Berry eyeliner and shadow pencil. Now, if I'm correct, Lord & Berry were used on Pirates of the Caribbean. They were the official makeup suppliers for eyeliner, like Johnny Depp's eyeliner and things like that. Could be wrong, but that's what I got told when I lived in London and worked in London. This is a shade 220 Soft Black. If you can see that, super pigmented. Lord & Berry pencils are amazing and they last really well throughout the day as well. If it's good enough for Jack Sparrow, then it's good enough for me. Next thing is another Lord & Berry product. It is the crayon lipstick. And this is, what shade? Oh, it doesn't say in the box. I've not tried any of the Lord & Berry lipsticks actually, so I'm quite intrigued. Ooh, to see what this is like. Oh, it's a chunky one. It's called Dangerous Red and it is beautiful. I don't know if you can see. Oh my god, let's have a little swatch. Now, this is what I would call a Gwen Stefani red. That is beautiful. I might put that on right now actually. It goes on really nice. It feels very moisturising. It's not dragging, it's not matte. And it smells amazing. It's really good. I was hoping there was going to be a lipstick in this box because I have it. I feel really naked if I don't wear lipstick. This may be my new favourite obsession. Yes! Converted. So that is the Lord & Berry 20100 Crayon Lipstick. And it honestly feels so nice. There's some red lipsticks that are like, I love, one of my favourite red lipsticks is Ruby Woo by MAC, which I know so many people love. But because it's matte, it's so drying and a lot of the time I find I'm dragging it across my lips. But this is so nice. I love it. Also, let me just, can we take a moment to appreciate my jumper, lads? Look. Dun 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 dun. Rob rats, though. Okay, next in the bag. Ooh. Lord & Berry number one fluid delicate micellar water makeup remover. I did not know they did skincare. I only knew they did, I really know Lord & Berry for their pencils. I have to smell it because I have to smell everything. It smells like coconut, but not like bounty coconut. Coconut like it's just fallen fresh off the tree. Nice. Well, I can't really try this as I don't really have any makeup on, but I'm sure that's wonderful. Oh, I just love getting makeup. I'm quite excited to try this one out when I have a full face of makeup to see how easily this takes it off. So when I use this, I shall make a little video or do a review. Ooh! The next one I have is, again, Lord & Berry Gentle Cream Cleanser. I don't know if there's any point to put my hand behind. I think the light's a little bit too bright. Yep, can't see that. Cream is formulated for all skin types with gentle vegetable ingredients. and it's suitable for a sensitive skin, which is great because my skin is so sensitive and I'm always quite worried about trying out new products on my skin because it just flares up pretty much anytime I put something new on. So it'll be interesting to see how this works. I like the bottle. This kind of looks like the MAC skin fluid, if that's what it's called, I can't remember. Skin and body makeup is what I'm trying to say. Let's give it a little. And also, it's got a funny texture. I'm gonna just put it on my skin. As I say, I don't have much makeup on. That feels so refreshing. It smells so beautiful. This is not greasy at all. This is one that you could definitely put on in the morning and just go out. Oh, it's cleanser, it's not moisturiser. I think I said it's moisturiser and it's absolutely not. But it still feels nice, so I'm just gonna leave it on my skin. Another thing I'm gonna say, actually, I didn't read out, is that Lord & Berry are cruelty-free. They're not tested on animals, so if you are vegan or you just don't want your products to be tested on animals, then Lord & Berry are a good company for that as well. Don't know if all of the products are vegan, but they're definitely not tested on animals. I would double check on the website if they're vegan friendly or not. Okay, next product, I'm going to reach it. It's like a lucky dip. I'm just putting my hand in and see what's coming out. Ooh, we have Linola Lips. This light is far too bright, you cannot see this. Anyway, Linola, hang on, try to focus. There we go. There you go. Linola Lips. Multi-purpose super balm. Says, says it's 100% natural. I don't know if this one is vegan or cruelty. Yep, cruelty-free against animal testing. Doesn't say if it's vegan friendly, but no, it won't be vegan friendly if it's got linola in it. It's vegetarian, it's not vegan, it's vegetarian because it has linolin in it. It says it has 101 uses. You can use it for extreme hydration, for extremely dry lips, skin patches, cuticles, elbows and more. So let me open this one and see. I've heard of this but I've not used it before. Cute packaging though. Love the packaging. I love this little pinup girl. She's cute. So it says, warm the ointment between fingers or apply directly onto the lips and skin. Now, I don't want to take this lipstick off, so I'm just going to apply it somewhere else. Ooh, it's super thick. Okay, because it's ointment. The texture reminds me of Pawpaw ointment. Again, I'm just going to pop it on my face because why not? That's nice, actually. Oh, look at the glow. Hi. Oh, hi. Okay, so there's another use for it. Highlighter. Ooh. Noted. Next product is... NARS. Ooh, it's a NARS product. It is NARS Radiant Creamy Concealer. Ooh. If you can see... There we go. I haven't used a lot of NARS products before, actually. I'm interested to see how this... I'm going to do a Jeffree Star and smell it. Oh, nice. Okay, it looks quite thick, which I like. This could be good to use as a primer before you put your eyeshadow on, so that could be quite good. I think what I'll do is another video where I'm actually going to use the products and see how we get on with those. Next product is... Oh, it's another Lord & Berry. Oh, eyebrow gel fixer. If you can see, red lipstick. I get it everywhere. I love wearing red lipstick, but I'm so messy with it. I remember one time my friend said to me, do you know you have red lipstick on your neck? To which I did not. I don't even know how it got there. So this is a Glacey, I think it's called Glacey, if this is how you pronounce it. Glacey Eyebrow Gel Fixer. And again, packaging is quite nice. Lord & Berry have got so many more products then I realised, ooh, nice big chunky wand. Quite excited to give this a try. I do love an eyebrow gel, actually. I might put this one in my kit because I have a lot of clients who have got the most beautiful, natural, full brows, and I don't like to put a product in them rather other than gel. I don't like to go in and put a pomade or a pencil when they're nice, full and bushy like they have them. I prefer just to stick a gel through them. Okay, ooh! I just saw another product. I'm quite excited to unscrew it out. Oh, I pulled that one out already. It's the Linola Lips. I thought there was another product, but I just forgot to put it back in the box. Anyway, there are three products left. Let's take a dip. Ooh, Hollywood California Glam Go Super Mud Clearing Treatment. Excited for this one. Excuse my disgusting lipstick stained hands. Sorry, I'm so bad at this. I'm just not a natural. There we go. Kind of, almost. So this is, doesn't say if it's cruelty free or vegan. I can find that out and let you know. Apply. So I'm not gonna put this on because it's a face mask or shell. Oh my god. Oh, that smells like Kevonia cough medicine. Super menthol. I love that. It's like menthol licorice. Oh my god. I don't know whether to put some on just now or not. Maybe. Maybe I'll just wait. Actually, I'm going to wait. I'm a bit scared in case it breaks my skin out. Okay, I've got two products left. So I'm going to go in and... Oh! Okay, second last product is another Lord & Berry. And it is Active Spa Lip Balm and Primer. I really should have looked at what was in the bag and pulled these out in order. Because I'm not going to be able to try these. So this is SPF 15, which is pretty cool. Again, not tested on animals. Oh, this is nice, nice packaging. Okay, so it's kind of like a lipstick. This would be nice to put on before you put your lipstick on, so you've got the protection of the SPF under your lipstick. In Scotland at the moment, we are having a belter of a summer. This has not happened in forever, and the weather is insane, it's so hot. I constantly have about 6 or 7 lip balms with me at all times. I have in my handbag, in my car, beside my bed, in my makeup room. I have them everywhere. I kind of have a phobia of not having a lip balm. Wherever I go, I have them in every pocket. I find lip balms everywhere. So I'm quite excited to try this one, especially as it's got SPF 15. This hot weather is just making my lips so dry, so I am quite excited to give that one a try. One more product. Oh, I remember what this one is. I remember. This is the MAC Hot and Naughty 2 Black Lash. Now, Dawn told me that she uses this mascara and that it's amazing. I've never used this one before from MAC, so I'm quite excited to give it a try. We have two wands. We've got this one, the normal wand, which is quite nice and chunky, which will be good for catching all of the lashes and giving some really good definition. And then up top we have the little wand for grabbing all those bottom lashes. So it's still quite chunky, but it's a little bit skinnier, so it'll be easier to get right underneath. I flipping love a good mascara. As you can see, I don't really wear much makeup on a day-to-day basis. Normally, if I'm honest, on a day-to-day basis, I do my eyebrows, my mascara, and some lipstick. So if I find a good mascara, I invest in it. So I'm looking forward to trying this one out as well. As I say, I think I'll do another video where I actually use all of the products. I did that totally backwards. I really should have planned that out instead of just doing a lucky dip. I'll do another video with all the products and let you know how I get on with them and create a look using the products. Thank you very much for watching my video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you haven't already, please subscribe to my channel and press the bell button to be notified when I upload another video. And thank you to my wonderful Dawn, who gifted me all of this wonderment. Fabulous. So I know we took a moment to appreciate my Rugrats jumper, but I also wanted to show you, take a moment of appreciation for these unicorn rainbow leggings and unicorn slippers. It's what I wear when I get comfy.